and figured out that wellness is really simple. So in 1990, in Dallas, Texas, with short white hair, I started teaching classes that just took off like crazy. And the mainstream media found me because they sniffed this stuff out. And I just told the truth. I mean, all I ever did was get on television and go, I blew off all the hosts, and I just went, listen to me. It doesn't matter what fitness level. You can modify to be fit. All you got to do is just work within your fitness level. I swear to God, if you're out of breath, then you're not in breath, and that's me. And I talked a million miles a minute, and millions of people responded. Then came the book people, then came the video people, blah, 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 blah. Well, then came the realization, and that's what happens to anyone who's at that level of anything. If you're actually creative and you're actually coming up with the ideas, which I was and always do and am, they rape it, you know? They just rape it. I mean, we're talking about huge corporations. We're talking about the 90s. There wasn't 75,000 options. I did the first episode of Space Ghost. I was down at CNN when they were still laughing at Ted Turner, like, you know, yeah, 24-hour news, my ass.
Wow.
It was true. You know, I faxed my first book back and forth to Simon & Schuster. It wasn't that long ago, people. It was only 15 years ago.
Right.
That long
right.
ago. So the mediums, I am absolutely the energy that people recognize as authentic, and it hasn't changed. I've gotten more energized with age. I have not matured one iota, I can promise you that. I'm more free. You know what I'm saying? It's like hot. I mean, you know, 50 is the new everything. 50 is the hottest thing to be. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
And the time is really exciting now because of the internet, because of interviews like this, because.
Right.
But that's why I came back. I came back to work because this message applies more than ever, and now the audience is changed. Everything's changed. People are smart. It's just like, yeah, you know what? She's got a point. I mean, you know, there's so much less resistance. Nobody wants to be overfat and unfit. It's not an empowering thing. Large and in charge is not true. You're throwing your body at patriarchy if you're slowly withering away overfat and unfit. And there's only one thing you can't do nothing about. It's your health. And if you lose that, to hell with it. And people are getting that now.
Right. Well, weight is an issue for women, but within the lesbian community, I'd like to know what your insights are. I mean,
it's actually interesting. I'm very disliked in the lesbian community as a lesbian woman. And it's interesting why. Because there's been a lot of resistance for a long time. I totally respect it. My women, I'm 52, you know, my women are the women, the Dorothy Allisons and the Andrea Dworkins and the, you know, the women of the 70s who laid this shit down.
Love it.
Who really did make a stand. There's no feminist movement in this country. There's not even a good bowel movement. And the lesbian movement is so fractioned because they're doing what patriarchy wants them to do, and that is considering they're being the good wives. You know, I mean, there's everybody, the LBG, HIJK, LMNOP. I mean, everyone's considered, everyone's everything. You know, God forbid you just say you have to be woman born. It's ridiculous what's going on. I'm not part of any movement or any group at all. I mean, if the L word is representative of what lesbians are, I want to go and hang myself. It's ridiculous. And the women aren't rallying together, and there is no movement. And the fact of the matter is, I have spent much time, I've worked with, I've done a lot with the most radical artists in the lesbian world, and when you have all of them sitting in a room saying, you know what, I've been pretending for years that I'm large and in charge and this is my body image and screw patriarchy, the fact is I hate the way I look and feel and I'd love to lose 50 pounds. There's a new thinking now. I don't care what your politics, you cannot be fat and healthy. You can be fat and sew your own clothes, you can be fat and happy, you can be fat and whatever the hell you think you are, but you cannot be fat and healthy because fat kills, number one. Number two, if you want to participate in patriarchy, then slowly kill yourself with disgusting food and no oxygen. That's the way. There's freedom. There's freedom, women. It's ridiculous, and there's been a lot of rebellion. I mean, I'm the only woman who has ever been boycotted inside the Michigan Women's Music Festival.
Oh, that's really interesting. How did that happen?
The only one. And I had 200 bloody women personally apologize to me. They were all young dykes, 19-year-olds who do nothing, and who put up posters and did the stuff. And I had the owners of the festival go around and say, young one, this is my land, not yours. And how dare, like, this years I've been going through this as a dyke. I mean, I'm a lesbian woman, but I don't pay any attention to it because the politics of the lesbian community are horrifying. And they're choking themselves. I mean, it's really true. Listen, I'm going to tell you a story, okay? You know the comic strip, Hothead Paisan, Lesbian Homicidal Terrorist. Do you know the comic strip?
Yes.
The Monsters, do you know it?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Okay, I was in a production of that. It was massive, huge, you don't even know, huge. The cast alone, forget it, ridiculous. Okay, so lesbian, don't ask. Okay, done. At the end of it, there were some fireworks, and this radical, supposedly lesbian woman came up and said, listen, about the fireworks, I really think that women who are recovering from war are going to be upset by that, so blah, blah, blah. And And the next day after we did Hothead, there was a 12-step meeting put up for Italian, lesbian, Americans who are offended by the play. And I said, you know you've hit it when there's a 12-step meeting that Dykes have created within a day. It's just ridiculous what's going on. And I don't care who you are. Nobody designs over fat and unfit. Nobody sits down and says, you know what, I have to be a good 120 pounds overweight. Nobody says that because nobody wants to be unfit because it doesn't feel good. It's not productive. It's not, you're not connected to your body when you're diseased and unoxygenated and weak and tired. And that's what being unwell is. I don't give a shit what your politics are. So the discussion is serious now. And the real leaders, I mean, I just had the privilege of spending time with Mary Daly and Sonia Johnson. You want to know what feminists are, sisters? Sit with those two women for about a half a second. They're not jerking around with this stupid discussion. They're not including every tranny, tranny gender. They're not having meetings every 35 seconds and running to therapy. They're actually doing the action of feminism. And those are the women I go to. When you're sitting next to Mary Daly, you really don't worry much about the politics of the day. Whatever.
Right. I think probably you're the only one who's ever even mentioned Mary Daly to me. I mean,
it's... Oh, God. Well, let me tell you something. I've met a lot of people. Believe me when I tell you. I mean, I have run-ins with Dolly Parton. I have run-ins with Rosie. You don't even know, in the middle of an airport. I have never, because I'm me, and I, you know, whatever. You either like me or you don't. It doesn't offend me. I got my life. I do my thing. I tell the truth. Whatever.
Right.
I was nauseous. I almost threw up when I had the privilege of meeting Mary. I almost threw up. I didn't know what to do with myself.
Right.
I was out of my mind. And I almost fainted, like Jade and Sonia. But what was really interesting is I met her personally, and then I was in the audience where she was speaking. And when they walked Mary down the aisle, and I started weeping.
Oh, my God, yeah.
It touched me. It was like, and I photograph births. I photograph underwater births. And there was a reverence that was stunning. The audience was stunned when they walked her down the aisle. It was crazy. And it touched me so deeply. So, you know, go to the women who go to the pioneers. They're alive women. They don't even know. They don't know their her stories. They don't. It's terrible what's happened. It's actually heartbreaking for the women who have been doing it. It's heartbreaking. But, you know, what the hell? And now with the word life, we're screwed. And now with everybody, we're screwed. It's getting worse. It's bad. That's just what it is. But the fact of the matter is, you got to be a complete idiot to denounce oxygen. You just have to be a fool. You know what I'm saying? What I do for my life's work is being taken very differently. But for years, I've been, you know, you want women to look like Barbie, and you walk around in high heels, and you wear makeup, and you do this. I mean, I'm beyond a lipstick lesbian. I'm on every track. Well, that's what happened just recently. Gay Pride, I was asked to march behind the Dykes on Bikes, which is such a privilege. And what an honor. What an amazing group of women. But anyway, and we stopped along the way to honor the women who, they were 80 years old. Oh, my God. I mean, such dykes that you just want to bow to them.
Mm-hmm.
And so many beautiful gay boys were hanging out of windows, and they were like, oh, my God, you are what I want to be every morning when I wake up. Like, you are that ridiculous. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, it was really beautiful, the reception.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, this isn't an opinion. Wellness is vital in this day and age. It's the most revolutionary thing, and stop acting like you're large and in charge, because you're not.
So when you say large and in charge, are you being literal?
It's like, no matter how many award-winning actresses stand on the podium and go, you know, I'm embracing my body image, and I'm healthy, and I'm just a larger, I'm being literal. To be over fat is not well, no matter how you look at it. It's not an opinion. If you want to live, and you want to change, and you want to stand, you can't stand without strength. That's literal. You can't stand the hell up without strength. You can't move and shift things without energy and strength. You can't denounce your physiology. You're not bigger than disease, I promise you. You know, you always hear, well, cancer is getting more aggressive. Cancer has not changed one iota. It's not getting more aggressive. Younger and younger people are getting it because the world is that toxic now. Not happening. Already happened. And, you know, I'm 52, people. I got a, you know, 30-year-old child. This is not an opinion. It's the truth. And
right.
If you want to listen, your life can change. You can be whatever you want to be. You can be lean, strong, healthy, and well. If you want to argue, go somewhere and argue. But, you know, call a meeting. I don't care.
So is this what... Is this what got you boycotted at Mitch Fest?
No, well, as always, it was a cowardly act. It always is a cowardly act. I was backstage because I was performing there. And so the kitchen staff did this skit, and I didn't even realize, I was in the audience, I didn't even realize that they were being as cruel as they were. It didn't dawn on me.